We'll start our English lessons with the text Flamingo. And as in Flamingo, we have already finished with the third chapter, that is Deep Water. Today we'll start with chapter 4, The Rat Trap by Selma Langerlof. Before we start with the lesson, let me first introduce you to the author. The author is Selma Langerlof. Selma Langerlof is a Swedish writer who in 1909 became the first woman to win the Nobel Prize for Literature. Her works are deep-rooted in folk tales and legends and stories of Sweden. Her stories remain lyrical and they are imaginative to an extent. She often borrows ideas and sentences from fairy tales, as we see in this chapter also. This chapter, The Rat Trap, starts in a fairy tale manner. Like the first line, the first sentence itself, it shows. It starts something like this. Once upon a time, there was a man. So we can see that this is the same pattern as that of a fairy tale. The whole story revolves around the concept of a rat trap. Rat trap? What is a rat trap? I hope you know. It's a trap laid down to catch these rodents. Rodents? Yeah, rats who destroy your crops. Okay, so the story talks about two universal themes. The first, that every human being has some essential goodness in him or her. And the second theme is that with love and affection, we can turn a monster into a normal human being. The protagonist or the central character of the story is a rat trap seller. He's a poor vagabond. Vagabond? Who is a vagabond? A vagabond is a person who wanders from place to place without a permanent home or a job. He goes, this particular vagabond, that is our rat trap seller, he goes around from city to city, from places to places, selling rat traps. Now, shall we start with the lesson? Yes. So I hope all of you are mentally prepared and set for it. So this rat trap seller, he goes from place to place, from city to city, selling the rat trap, which he makes by himself. And he does this with the materials that he gets from begging. He goes around begging, not just for the materials, but also for his livelihood. But the selling business, that is selling of rat trap and begging, they were not sufficient enough to move on with his life. So what he does is, he goes around with petty thievery. Petty thievery means stealing things, maybe pickpocketing you call it. Okay. So even after all this, even after having a business of rat trap selling and even after begging and petty thievery, he is unable to quench his hunger. And so we see him again in rags with sunken cheek and hunger. Hunger, it just gleams through his eyes. You can see his eyes searching for food. So, one day, when this particular rat trap seller, he was going around selling rat traps, an idea struck him. And this idea, it changed his outlook about the world. He thought that the whole world is like a rat trap. And this worldly rat trap uses bait in the form of riches, joys, shelter, food and clothing. Now, what is a bait? I hope you know. Yeah, you use it for fishing. Yes, a bait is a food that is placed in a trap to attract the animal, any animal. It might be any animal. For fishes, we generally use the bait as an earthworm. And for rat, yeah, I know, you'll come out with cheese. In Western countries, you can say, yeah, it's cheese. But in India, we would use something like potatoes. Yeah, definitely. Okay, so now this concept has come into his mind that the whole world is a rat trap. And we human beings are like rats. And we are going around this rat trap and waiting for our chance to be attracted by the bait. And as I told you earlier, this bait for human being, it's in the form of wealth, joy, shelter, food, clothing. Okay. And it's set. It's already set. And it's waiting. It's attracting each one of us towards itself. And when our rat trap seller thinks about all these concepts, he actually enjoys every bit of it. Okay. He derives a pleasure thinking ill about people all around the world. Actually, ill about people in the sense that he feels that all the people would be attracted towards this particular bait, and the worldly we would be trapped in this worldly rat trap and we would perish. Now, it's not his fault that he had a sadistic approach towards life and people. We cannot blame him for that, because we are what people make us, and we learn from what people show us and they give us. And the same thing has happened to the rat trap seller. People had always been very rude to him, and they showed their bitter face whenever he looked at them for any kind of help. Now you see, this rat trap seller, as he never had a house of his own, he might have been towards them, or he had been in their houses, maybe begging for a shelter. But no, nobody bothered. Nobody bothered even once to think about him. Why should they? Even we won't think about anyone who comes around in rags and with a rat trap dangling around the neck. Who will think about such a person? Why should we think? And let me ask you a question. If you were in the place of this rat trap seller, would you ever enjoy the life of deprivation where you are deprived to the core? No, no. Here the rat trap seller also was like that. He was deprived. He was never accepted by a community, by a society. People showed him the bitter face. They scolded him. They ran him out. They turned him out of their houses. Whenever he went there and begged for a shelter, maybe at night, they never took him seriously. So this rat trap seller also enjoyed thinking bad about them. Okay, he experienced an unusual pleasure thinking ill about such people who had never been kind to him. In his lonely path, whenever he used to go around all alone to sell his rat trap, he always thought about this concept of the worldly rat trap. And it gave him a kind of happiness and joy, and that enabled or motivated him to move on. And maybe this is the reason why we all make, means maybe the society is responsible to an extreme or to an extent to convert a normal person into such people, such criminals who go around stealing things. Okay, children, for today we stop here. We'll see in the next class, we'll see how life changes him with the passing of each day and how changes come about in his life. And we'll see how he turns into a normal human being with all the humane characters and starts thinking positive, changes his attitude, changes his sadistic approach. Okay, thank you, children. Goodbye. Please do stay indoor. Be safe during this period of lockout. Thank you.